All the class 10 students of St. Michael's Academy, welcome to another online physical science class. Here I am continuing as usual current electricity. So let's start. First I am starting with electric generator. An electric generator is a device with which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. It works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. So there are two types of electric generator. One is AC generator and another one is DC generator. So generators don't actually create electricity. Always remember this. Instead, they convert mechanical or chemical energy into electrical energy. They do this by capturing the power of motion and turning it into electrical energy by forcing electrons from the external source through an electrical circuit. So, just opposite of a generator, electric motor works. Remember this. So, principle of an electric generator. Generator works on the principle of electromagnetic induction discovered by Michael Faraday in 1831-32. And second one, Faraday's law. Based on the principle, actually, principle is based on Faraday's law. An electromagnetic field or EMF is induced in a conductor, that is a coil, when the magnetic field around it changes. The magnitude of the EMF is proportional to the rate of change of the field or rate of cutting flux, while its direction depends on the direction of the rate of change. So, these two are the basic principle of an electric generator. Faraday's law, you knew it because I told you before. So, first, AC generator. AC generator, also known as alternators, is a machine that converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. The generated electrical energy is in the form of an alternating current sinusoidal output waveform. The mechanical energy is usually supplied by steam turbines, gas turbines, and combustion engines. So, an AC generator converts mechanical energy into electrical energy in the form of AC. Okay, so what is the working principle? AC generators work on the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which states that electromotive force, EMF or voltage, is generated in a current carrying conductor that cuts a uniform magnetic field. This can either be achieved by rotating a conducting coil in a static magnetic field or by rotating the magnetic field that contains the stationary conductor. The preferred arrangement is to keep the coil stationary because it is easier to draw induced alternating current from a stationary armature coil than a rotating coil. You just see the diagram. One normal generator diagram I have given. And the generator parts, means AC generator, yellow color AC generator, and the generator parts separately I have shown over there. It's an original diagram. This is not a diagrammatic structure. It's an original diagram. So, the armature, in working principle, you can say, in short, the armature, when rotates in the magnetic field or field magnet, it cuts the magnetic field lines and thereby induced current is linked with the coil. The direction of the induced current is determined by Fleming's right-hand rule. The current flows out alternately through the brushes in reverse directions. The output current is alternating current. Now, maybe you want to ask me a question. What are brushes? What are armature? I'm going to give you the answer. So first, components. The various components of an AC generator are field, armature, prime mover, rotor, stator, slip rings. So we are here, we have stated the purpose of each component. First one, field. The field consists of coils of conductors that receive a voltage from the source and produce magnetic flux. The magnetic flux in the field cuts the armature to produce magnetic flux. This voltage is the output voltage of the AC generator. In the next slide, I have given you the diagram. That means diagrammatic structure according to your book so that you can tally it. Armature, the part of an AC generator in which the voltage is produced is known as an armature. This component primarily consists of coils of wire that are large enough to carry the full load current of the generator. Mover, the component used to drive the AC generator is known as a prime mover. The prime mover could either be a diesel engine, a steam turbine, or a motor. Here one thing I'm discussing, in your book, diagram given and the description given, description of components given, so they have shown this according to diagram, but here I have not mentioned this. In generally I have given because no need to draw the diagram in exam. This is not in your syllabus, but here I have given you the diagram for easily explaining. Now other components. Next one is rotor. The rotating component of the generator is known as a rotor. The generator's prime mover drives the rotor. Based on the type of generator, this component may either be the armature or the field. The rotor will be the armature if the voltage output is generated there. The rotor will be the field if the field excitation is applied there. Next one is stator. The stator of an AC generator is the stationary part. As the rotor, this component may be the armature or the field, depending on the type of generator. The stator will be the armature if the voltage output is generated there. The stator will be the field if the field excitation is applied there. Slip rings. Slip rings are electrical connections that are used to transfer power to and fro from the rotor of an AC generator. That means in periodic motion rather. They are typically designed to conduct the flow of current from a stationary device to a rotating one. Now see the diagram. We in between two magnets, one is North Pole, another one is South Pole. The total structure is there with two brushes, slip rings, commutator, armature, rotor, stator, everything is there. One more thing I want to add that I have given you more points than your book. So please try to write down from this line so that your marks will increase. Now, I am talking about the DC generator or dynamo. Definition first, a dynamo is an electrical generator that creates direct current using a commutator. Simply put, a device that makes direct current electric power using electromagnetism. It is basically a DC generator, that is an electrical machine which converts mechanical power into direct current or DC electrical power. A simple DC generator consists of a coil of wire rotating in a magnetic field. However, it uses a split ring commutator rather than the two slip rings found in alternating current, that is AC generator. So this is the difference in between AC and DC generator or dynamo. Some bike lights use a type of DC generator called a dynamo to run the lamps while the wheels are turning. Maybe in left turning or right turning, some lights are working in case of bike following this DC generator mechanism. Now first see the first diagram. DC generator, and this is a diagram. Armature, brush, commutator. Everything shaft, everything has been shown. And the next one, the mechanism shown, how the bulb is glowing. Here also two magnets are there, one North Pole, another one in South Pole. In between this one, commutator is there, armature is also there, ABCD. Brushes are there, split rings are there. So, here armature coil, the large number insulated copper wire is wound on an iron core forming a rectangular armature. Here you can say ABCD. field magnet armature is placed between two pole pieces north and south of a strong magnet. The pole pieces are made concave to provide a radial field. Split ring commutator, two split rings are there, R1 and R2. According to your book, I am saying here, according to this diagram, green color split rings are there. From the commutator to which the ends of the armature coil are connected. You can see clearly because this is a coloring diagram. Next, brushes are there. Two carbon brushes press against the commutator. Load, the output is connected to the load. So, what is the working mechanism of this generator? When the coil of the generator rotates in the magnetic field, potential difference is induced in the coil. This induced potential difference gives rise to flow of current to the load always in the same direction. Now, the mechanical work to be done in these generators for rotating the armature coils is done in the following two ways. One is thermal power generation and the second one is hydroelectric power generation. So, first one, thermal power generation. The electric energy or electrical energy is produced by burning fossil fuels such as coal, coke or oil like petrol, diesel, kerosene, etc. In West Bengal, there is a thermal power plant at Bandel. So, a thermal power station is a power station in which heat energy is converted to electric power. In most, a steam-driven turbine converts heat to mechanical power as an intermediate to electrical power. Water is heated, turns into steam and drives a steam turbine which drives an electrical generator. See the first diagram, the total process has been shown. Now second one is hydroelectric power generation. In this type of power generation, hydraulic, that is water energy, is converted to electric energy. You know, hydraulic word is related to water. Generally, water acquires kinetic energy by falling from a higher to a lower level, then uses the energy to work a water turbine, which in turn drives a generator. There is a hydroelectric power plant at Maithan in West Bengal, near to Asansol. So, hydroelectric power is produced with moving water at hydro power plants. Water flows through a pipe or penstock, then pushes against and turns blades in a turbine to spin a generator to produce electricity. Run of the river systems, where the force of the river's current applies pressure on a turbine. See the second diagram, that this hydraulic power station, hydroelectric power generation has been shown dramatically. All the waters are collected, then this process has been started. Thank you, students. For any doubts or queries, please email me at sudeshna1.sma@outlook.com. Even you need to send your regular physical science assignment in this given email ID. More than that, if you want to send any problems from test paper, that also you can send. Already some students are sending and I have already given the answer. So please respond and start doing the test paper, start solving the test paper.